Hello, it is Toast, and welcome back to Portal 2. That's the last time we made it to Old Aperture, and we did some of the blue goo puzzles. And yeah, that's all I remember. It's been a little bit since last time I recorded stuff. Or at least this, definitely this. Alright, there we go. Continue. This is aperture. Alright, yep, we haven't found Gladys yet. Which sucks, I really like her. Or at least for this game, because she's not trying to kill you the whole game. Crap. What was I doing? Gotta be something up there. Ooh. So I feel like I can. Oh my god, can I action? Okay, is that for? I feel like that's, would be not progressive.
I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
I fucked up. Let's try that again. I think I need to keep a portal on the outside open. Alright, I just gotta find. Alright, I gotta find where. That was okay, then I can put the order. It's up there. Alright, or I can do blue up here. And then actually, I don't think it matters as long as I have. So I gotta put the portal up there.
I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
Alright. Oh. Oh, it's constant now. Okay. Okay. I like the noises it makes when you jump. God, though. Sorry for being quiet. I'm just trying to concentrate. Okay. Come on. I thought maybe I could jump over and off it. Good. Eh. It happens. Over there. Oh my god, I didn't hit the wall. Okay. Okay. That's always the problem. I can't leave. I hate putting down a game, like, for a while and coming back because then I have no idea, like, what I'm doing, what's going on. Yeah. I thought I was doing good, and now I have no idea what to do. Because how am I supposed to leave to be able to get the to get over there? Without the portal being right there.
Coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Oh, great. Thanks, Cave Johnson.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're gonna need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast.
Yikes.
Keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Hi, Ref. A future you tries to warn you about the test. Don't listen. God, this is so fucking ridiculous. Alright. Far. Oopsies. Wait. Oh. Okay. Okay. Let's try that again, but without fucking it up this time. Okay.
If you're hearing this, it means you're taking a long time on the catwalks between tests. The lab boys say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm on the beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Hustle for you some work, though. Now let's solve this thing.
At least, like, psychological advancements were not done ethically. So, I'll give him that. I'm sure that goes for a lot of other science, too, but... So, I don't disagree.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation... and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there will always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem.
But yeah, so as much as obviously don't ignore ethics, but I don't disagree with Team Johnson though. Of course, science isn't worth all the danger and stuff and the torture, but still, he's technically not wrong. Alright, where can I go to get out of here? Window. I don't want to leave. I get stuck at the exit of this area, like, oh my god. Is there like a button or something? Ashtray, because it was like the 50s, who's that? Who's that, right? Oh, it's Kip Johnson, alright. I'll call this a video for this part anyway. Bye!